Graves pops in and out of the cafe like a stray cat over the next couple weeks, never staying for long. I still don't know what he's doing when he's gone. The days come and go and we settle into a routine. Everybody shows up and does their thing. I'm getting better at my job, and I'm getting better at some other stuff, too. Hey, Mochi, check it out! Mochi opens one eye and thumps his tail once against the side of the couch. I'm almost totally sure he understands me now, somehow. When I talk to him, it's not like I'm talking to a sentient pillow anymore. He actually acknowledges what I say and responds. It's not that weird to talk to your pets anyway, right?
Do it all the time.
Yeah, I think it's pretty normal. I mean, it's not like he's literally talking back to me. That would be weird. It happened earlier.
But we just ignored it.
I set two cola cans next to each other, then take a step back. Are you watching? You better be watching.
Oh, she's like,
Okay, here we go. I concentrate and... Are you learning magic?
Oh, no.
The cola cans flutter apart into long ribbons, like potato peels. They collapse on each other and form a jumbled mess of aluminum.
Perfect.
There's some soft crunching while the ball of soda can wobbles around a bit. Shapes begin to emerge from the ball of aluminum ribbons. Arms, legs, ears. Then, before you know it...
It's a crudely shaped cat.
Ta-da! A soda can sculpture of a cat. It's you!
Oh.
Mochi makes a little huffing noise, then closes his eyes. I set the cat sculpture aside with all the others.
Others?
Well.
Have they been, like, attempting this, like, every day? They progressively, like, went from, like, being, like, really crappy, like, it was just, like, a ball of... And Avery was like, it looks like you, Mochi. And Mochi's like, sure.
What? You don't think it looks like you? You're the worst audience. I'm going to show this to the guys at the cafe. They'll appreciate it. I think I feel comfortable enough with my magic, I guess I might as well call it, to bring it up to everybody.
Surprise!
I can demonstrate it now, after all, so it's not like they have reason to not believe me. The real problem now is figuring out how the heck to bring it up. Hey guys, I have magic!
Okay, that's nice, Avery.
Look, I'm gonna do sculptures of all of you.
Yeah, okay, that's okay.
Nice. That's nice, Avery.
No, really!
It's like, I just feel like, if you can believe... That people turn into cats. This isn't that much of a stretch.
I love how like, nonchalant Avery is about, like, hey, I can just do magic now. You know, whatever.
More worried about what people will think about it. I'm going to mull that one over a bit, but I suppose a day or two more of planning won't hurt. Yeah, I can make cat sculptures out of my laundry. I should start getting ready for work. I had a couple of days off, but I've still been going in to hang out with everybody almost every day. What can I say? I really like everybody there. Some more than others. Okay, one especially more than others, but whatever.
What? When did that happen, Avery?
Who did we accidentally choose?
Oh, shoot.
Oh, wait. Are we already on a path? It's not, this is the choice point.
We'll see.
Oh, shit. If it's Graves, I'm going to be really upset.
We can restart if it's Graves.
But again, first things first. We'll worry about the cat situation, And then I'll worry about the cute coworker situation.
I did not know this was a development theory.
What?
Unless it is a... Unless there's still a choice that's about to come up.
Yeah, maybe they're, like, leading up to... I hope. I don't know. I guess we'll see.
Yeah.
I grab my keys... Smush my face into Mochi's to say goodbye. He hates it. And then head on my way.
Marie?
I like Mochi.
Mochi's like unibrow or whatever.
I haven't seen any trace of that creepy guy since I saw him a while back while I was sleepwalking. So I've started trying that other route to and from work when I need a change of scenery. It's not a great change, to be honest. There's still a lot of rusty junk lining the road, and it feels like I see more every time I come down this way. It's so deliberately placed that there's no way it wasn't on purpose. There's a stack of old car parts that almost looks like a tower if you look at it the right way. It's almost artful. I briefly saw that as awful.
That too.
Yeah, that bike looks gross.
Today, though, there's a different addition to the walkway.
Is it a meow?
Graves? He's right there, very much human, standing over the rusty, decrepit bike. He's so lost in thought, I wonder if he even notices I'm here. Graves? What's up?
Oh. Oh, Avery. Just assessing the litter around the cafe.
Yeah, it looks like someone's been using this walkway as a trash dump.
So they have.
Do you think it's one of the shop owners around here?
I know the culprit. The true matter is to properly deal with its disposal.
That's not our job. If you know who it is, make them do it.
Regretfully, I do not believe we can stop him.
It's my twin, isn't it?
Actually, you, Avery, while you were sleepwalking.
You look so serious. I mean, I can't blame him. This is an eyesore, and it's probably hurting business, and it's all my fault. What a jerk my evil self is. Who is it?
Nobody you know. Don't worry about it.
Well, I guess if he's not gonna stop, we should just start cleaning it up. I'll help carry some of it. I roll up my hoodie sleeves and reach out to grab the rusty bike hand. Hmm? Graves' hand? Oh no, are we on his route?
No, we don't want this.
His fingers coiled tightly around my wrist so quickly I didn't even see him move.
Oh.
Don't touch it.
His eyes hold an intense stern glow as his stare bores into me. For just a moment, I feel that chill claw up my spine again. Oh, okay. Sorry.
Forgive me. It's too dangerous to do this without the correct procedure. You haven't learned enough yet.
What does that mean?
Magic? This is a lot more complicated than just picking up trash, huh?
Please, don't worry about it.
I can't help wondering if this is related to some other weird things I've seen around here, you know?
I'd rather you just focus on the cafe and leave this to me. Please don't worry about it.
You're so opaque. I seriously don't get you at all.
Good.
I've been hearing that since before I could speak. I'm used to it by now.
I wish you'd just tell me straight up what's going on.
Consider it a management problem. How is the job treating you? You do enjoy it here, yes?
Well, aside from the boss... Oh, hey. Well, maybe if I had a boss that told the truth, it'd be easier.
No need to be contentious.
I think there's every need to be contentious.
I'm doing the best I can. I truly am sorry for the mess, Avery.
I'm not the one you should be apologizing to. Talk to the rest of the staff about that.
Best case scenario, this will be dealt with soon, and we can all forget about it.
And if the best case doesn't happen?
Then we'll have a new bridge to cross. Well, you'd best head in. Wouldn't want to be late, after all.
You gonna write me up or something if I am?
I don't think I need to after Finley got through with you for making her open by herself.
Shoot, you're right. Well, later.
Till then.
There isn't much time until he opens, so I hurry off to the cafe.
I don't know, that felt like part of the story, so...
Yeah.
I think so.
I think we're okay.
I was
okay.
Like, hand touch worries, but I think it was a warning hand touch rather than a sexy hand touch.
Yeah. We're okay. We're not. Avery, there you are. I was starting to get worried.
Sorry. I got sidetracked on the way here. I ran into Graves.
I guess talking to the boss counts at work. Counts as work. Huh.
No, it doesn't. Graves couldn't keep hold of a topic if it was stapled to his hand.
We hurriedly get to work finishing pre-open setup. Though it doesn't really matter because it's a slow morning. First person to come through the front door isn't even a customer, it's Graves.
Fancy meeting you here. You want some coffee? The usual? Not right now, thank you. Please pay me no mind. I'll be in and out today. Maintenance work.
Finally. The sink in the kitchen has been backing up something fierce lately.
Not that kind of maintenance, my friend. Security improvements.
Da 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 da.
Eep.
He blows through the building. Literally, because he turned into a bat. And disappears through the back door as quickly as he arrived. Reese watches him go, and takes a few wavering steps toward the door before deciding against it. I guess even Reese can't outboss the boss. Security improvements, huh? What the heck is that supposed to mean?
Something to do with the creepy dude.
Yeah. That was weird. Well, back to work, huh?
Yeah. It's hard to focus on work when I can see Graves pacing back and forth in front of the big glass storefront. Luckily, it's a slow day, so I can excuse myself every so often to peek in on him. I think I just saw him bury something under a loose tile. It looked like a skull. At one point, I dip my head out to see what he's doing, and he's just standing there, staring at the wall, tracing a picture on it with his finger.
It's red rum.
Sure, he's just doing it to look busy, but then I catch a glimpse of something, like light reflecting off a piece of metal on the wall itself. It flashes for a moment, and then it's gone.
Ooh, is he making, like, magical protection?
Ooh. I think maybe it's like a pentagram or something.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm seeing things. Maybe he's doing something to the building. Something arcane, I guess. But even if he is, why? Why is he suddenly so concerned with security? Is he setting, like, a magic anti-theft alarm or something?
Yeah, it's gonna sick the amethyst on whoever breaks it.
Or is it something more sinister? Can't help but think of his weird behavior this morning and his focus on the rust piles. Something must be coming. Something as serious as the cat curse. As it is the amethyst. He's just gonna leave us in the dark. I've gotta do something. It's time I finally talk to someone about magic, the book, the curse, everything. And my love. I hope she doesn't kick me out of the kitchen first. Oh, are we on the Mason route?
Oh, Mason.
I love Mason. Oh, please tell me that we're on the Mason route, not the Graves. Yeah.
I mean, I'd be okay with that, though I would prefer one of the guys. I do like Mason, though.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm intruding whenever I'm here. I'm never sure if it's Mason's aura or if it's because cooking is the most mysterious magic of all. What if she doesn't believe me? What if she thinks I'm stupid?
Avery, everyone else turns into cats.
I don't think that's going to happen. I'm starting to figure out how to read her. I don't think she's that type of person. I hope. I don't know. It's hard to figure out without feedback, you know? She's warmed up to me, at least. I can tell that much. I don't know if she's taking pity on me because I can barely feed myself.
Yeah. That's it.
Yeah, Avery and me have something in common. Or if... Well, never mind. No use speculating. Looking at me standing here and gawking, I better not slack off. I try to make myself look busy. Oh, she's not even paying attention. You know, it's funny. Before I met Mason, I didn't know cooking could be so artistic. Watching her prepare meals is like a dance. I think this is probably for... Yeah. Today's special is French toast with little cat shapes seared into the bread. I didn't know that was a thing you could do, but here she is, making this adorable food as if she's been doing it since birth.
She's like, I have been doing this since birth.
Been doing this since before birth.
I'm not even going to speculate on that any further. Continue, please.
Reincarnation, that's what I meant.
Okay.
It makes me want to learn to cook. Could I do that, like, ever? She's a natural. I don't think I could ever learn like that.
Catching flies.
Yeah?
Mouth open, staring. Gonna catch flies.
Oh, you're right. Ah. I guess she was paying attention.
Do you come in here for something, or should I charge admission for the show?
Sorry. If I'm begging you, I can come back. If this is a bad time, I mean?
Didn't say I didn't like it.
Oh, she's blushing.
Don't mind the company now and again.
She glances up and flashes me a... Is that... It is! A smile. Wow. Now what?
I don't know.
Is this flirting?
I don't know.
I Oh, haha, thanks. I mean...
Wait.
Hold on, let me try that again. Smooth moves, Gray. Way to get thrown off by a mild maybe flirt. So, I wanted to ask you something. Talk about the cat curse.
Talk while I work. Can't burn the toast.
Oh, okay. So, you know, the cat curse and all.
I'd hope so.
Right. So, I think I figured out how to break it. I figured that it'd at least warrant a look, but she didn't even glance up. Is she excited or what? I mean it, like, I never turned into a cat, right? I think I reversed it before it could take hold. I could probably do the same for you.
Nah.
What? That's not what I expected. I didn't think she'd burst into tears dance around the kitchen or something. But, nah? Just, nah? If you don't believe me, I can...
I believe you. Just don't need it. Bet the others will be thrilled.
You what? Don't need it? What do you mean?
I'm fine with being a cat. It doesn't cause me problems. It's cool you figured it out.
Definitely not what I expected. What do you even say to that? I feel stupid. Like, even more than usual. Oh, Avery. I'm... okay. Okay, this is fine. Get your head in the game, Gray. We can do this. We have, you know, 4 different people to give advice. Who are, you know, speaking in my head.
Avery's just, like, having these illusions with these, like, 20-something-year-old kids just, like... talking in their head.
Yes.
This happens to all our protagonists. I feel bad for them.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm misunderstanding. You want to be a cat forever? You'll be stuck here for the rest of your life.
First real job I've had. Not gonna throw that out.
Hey, mine too. But, I don't know, doesn't it bother you that you can't go anywhere or do anything?
I go places.
Where? Home? There's lots of stuff you can do besides work and sleep. You should be able to go shopping.
Don't like shopping.
See movies.
Graves has DVDs.
Go on dates. Oh, that's silent. She slaps another piece of toast on the griddle, but I see that tick. Her mouth is twitching. That's a good sign, I think. She pointedly flips the toast, letting the sizzle drown me out for a second. God, it smells good in here, like vanilla and cinnamon. Does she go home smelling like that? Would she smell like that if she wasn't a cat when she goes home? Or...
Bad thoughts, Avery.
Yeah, moving on. Won't you at least try with me? I've got this magic manual at my place, and we could look up how to break the curse and try it out if you want, of course.
Thought you said I couldn't date as a cat.
Ah, crap! Oh, I meant not as a date. I mean,
relax. It's a joke. Won't hurt to take a look.
Huh. Really?
But I got some stuff to take care of. Give me your address. I'll come after.
Okay, sure. I can text it to you.
Can't check my phone as a cat.
Yeah, whoops. Let me find a paper and pen.
I'll be here all day.
You're right. I won't rush then, I'll walk. Avery, what?
I'm so excited.
Oh my god, it's so adorable.
Avery just like started having a crush like in one day.
I know.
Yeah, it did seem very sudden.
Yeah.
I mean, I really like basically all the characters except for dating Graves.
Yeah, it's like I like him as a character, but it'd just be too many things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I run away before I can make even more of an idiot of myself. Oh my god, could I have been more awkward? Why do I turn into a blathering idiot every time I see her? I thought I had game. The only game I got is Twiddlywinks.
Who uses that word?
I feel like I'm about to burst into shame flames.
Jeez.
In the news today, trash heap of a 19-year-old kid opened their dumb mouth and then spontaneously combusted from awkwardness. Oh, Avery's 19. I thought they were a little older than that.
That seems so young now.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I thought they were like at least, I don't know, 23 or something.
Out of college.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I gotta get it together before anybody else sees me. Everybody sees you.
Avery.
Oh, hell. No way, it's not Finley, but Reese is almost as bad. I busy myself with organizing the cat toys. The red one is longer than the yellow one, but this other red one is shorter. If I arrange them by size, it'll be an ugly rainbow. But if I do it by size and color, it'll...
Avery, are you ignoring me?
What? Of course not. What is up?
I wanted to see if you'd be willing to close today, but if you're going to pick up and put down the same toy over and over, I'll find someone more capable.
No, it's fine. I was just testing its weight. You know, getting a feel for how the cats like it.
Right.
It passes the test. Good to go.
Unless, of course, you have plans. Of course not.
Look at that smug mug. He knows full well what he's doing. Why is everybody here so noisy?
Shh.
Why is everybody here so noisy? Nosy. I resent that. I have plenty of plans, like, all the time. I have a very healthy nightlife.
Of course you do. But not often with other people, I imagine. Especially not co-workers. Aw, man, Reese.
I knew it. He does know. Is he good at reading people? Or is my poker face that bad?
Gross. I'll have to call Landry for cleanup if you don't pick that jar up. So, that's half the cleanup we'd have to do if things get messy with you and Mason.
What? I don't know what you mean.
Look, just a friendly word of warning. From a splendid assistant manager to his loyal employee. I heard you talking in the kitchen, and be careful with her. And with yourself.
What do you mean?
You keep such a distance. I don't know what happens if you two get close. That's all. It's just a hunch. Might be nothing. But I listen to hunches.
You're only worried about our only chef quitting.
That too, but I don't know. It's just a feeling, all right? I'd try to help and get put on the stand.
I'm not gonna thank you for eavesdropping, dude. You're just finding excuses to be nosy.
Well, you say that now, but someday, when you are older and more mature, you'll thank me. I love Reese, too.
Yeah, I love him.
This is why I want to aim for him next. Is that a Graves impression? Are you trying to imitate Graves right now?
Oh,
yeah. What? No. Jeez, of course not.
You are. You even copied his intonation. Oh my god, you're such a little kid.
I am absolutely not. We're the same age, you and me. You can't call me a kid.
All the more reason you shouldn't act like my dad, kid. Nobody should listen to me for advice, so they definitely shouldn't listen to you.
I beg your pardon. I'm definitely the more mature one here. I'm a manager for a reason.
Haha, okay. I bet I could be just as good a manager as you. And then I...
Ahem.
The words die in our throats and we freeze. We whip our heads toward the kitchen. Mason's there, hands on hips, staring at us like she can see our futures.
You're real loud.
I heard everything.
Sorry. We'll be quiet. She doesn't look mad. She looks amused. Like she's trying to hide a smile. Maybe my mind's playing tricks.
Sorry, Mason. I'll discipline them properly.
What? You were just as bad.
Don't be too tough. It's a real fragile one.
She makes a noise. Is that a laugh? Then she disappears. Did Mason laugh at me? Or with me? Probably mostly at. Maybe both. Point is, I've never heard her laugh, period. Beast looks as incredulous as I feel. I can feel his shocked gaze from here. You know what? It feels pretty cool to get special treatment from Mason. Now who's got his jaw on the ground? Clean up on aisle, Reese.
Oh my god. You can't just steal my line. That's so uncreative.
Like I care. Mason kinda sorta smiled at me. She's gonna come over tonight. Reese can keep blabbing until the end of the shift for all I care. I've got other things to think about.
Aww.
Yay.
Mason. Boy, is it a long day, though. I divide my attention between checking the front and the back of the cafe. The front to see if Graves is still there. He isn't. And the back to see if Mason is still there. Of course she is. It doesn't make the time go any faster. I finally find a spare pen and paper to write my address for Mason. We have to hide all the pens so Ayn doesn't chew them up. Ayn? Hunting for one thankfully eats up some of my time. It's like a scavenger hunt. Gotta make this nice and easy to read. I spend a little extra time putting some flourishes on my handwriting so it's clear enough. Then I draw a map, and a few cats, and flowers, and...
Is it gonna be like they're drawing on Reese's drawing pad?
Oh, I'm getting carried away. I shove the paper in my pocket and get back to work. Hopefully Reese or Landry didn't see me messing around. Eons later, the sun gets to that point where it turns into a red giant and slowly melts the earth.
What?
It said eons later.
Okay.
Where it melts the windows at that angle I held. Hey. That means it's about time for Mason to head out. She had a really long shift. Sure enough, she's already out of her apron and the pots and pans are all nicely stacked. Oh man, I should have been in here helping her clean instead of messing around with doodles. bonding opportunity missed. Hey, Mason. I brought you directions, like you asked, you know.
I remember like it was yesterday.
Is that another joke? Ha ha. Okay, here you go. I hope you like it. Hope you like it. Just bury me alive.
Direction.
Avery is so cute. I hand her the paper, all neatly folded up into a triangle. Well, I tried to make it neat. It's kind of lumpy.
Also, it's not a triangle. It's more like a ball.
Another smile plays across her face.
Long as it doesn't get me lost, it's fine.
Okay, good. I drew a map too. Put my artistic skills to use. You know, just in case. Okay, so see you later then, I guess. Where are you going?
Don't worry about it. See ya.
Yeah, okay. Bye. And she puts the paper in her mouth. Well, yeah, how is she going to carry it if she's a cat?
Yeah.
I mean, not eating it. She fits it between her teeth and waves farewell before she steps out the back door. Why would she do that?
Turns into a cat, Avery.
She vanishes.
Have you not been paying attention, Avery? Get with the program.
No, you really are a dumb cat.
You and Mochi suit each other. I peek out after her. There's a scruffy orange cat with a lumpy paper triangle in its mouth. Oh. Makes sense.
Oh my gosh.
Not like she has pockets. I better get cleaned up and everything too, right? Gotta get back and get ready. I rush through the closing tasks and mess up probably 75% of them. For example, I leave the door open.
Oh dear.
My head's way gone by now. I'm checked out. Poor Landry has to clean up after me, like closing the door. Eventually, he tells me to just head home. I think that's just because he knows it'll be faster to do it himself. Sorry, Landry.
Why, Avery, why?
Sorry, I didn't take your route.
It's because I'm the most boring one, isn't it?
Yep. But at least you're not Graves.